So one common thing in game development is you design a game system and you build it and you test it and you refine it until you get it pretty happy with it. And then as all these systems come together, you look at how they're adding up in terms of the game performance, how fast it runs on various hardware, and you realize that you need to do some optimization. So we've been doing a lot of that lately on a variety of things, on the animal AI, on the GUI interfaces, on the wayfinding, and on the scent system. We've shown the scent system before, and we've had it where we're pretty happy with how it works in the game, but we have a lot of scents now showing in the game, and they're really slowing things down. So our crack Unity developer, Nick, has been undertaking an overhaul. He started with the floating scents earlier this winter, and in March tackled the ground scents, which are really essential in the game to find the herd, since in WolfQuest 3 there aren't going to be those zones like they're in their old game, like elk live here. No, elk are wherever you might find them out there. And so following the floating scents and then following their tracks, the ground scents that they leave behind as they walk around, is really an essential part of making the game playable. So we need to have thousands of these ground scents that various animals in the game leave as they move around. And that was really slowing things down. So about a month ago, Nick dove into that. And it turned out to be a much deeper dive than any of us expected, and took him much of the month to basically re-engineer a whole new particle system for these ground scents, the scent trails. And so he's using some flashy new techniques like GPU instancing to get thousands and thousands and thousands of particles of different colors, of different alpha values or transparency values, all rendering at the same time on screen without the huge performance impact that we were having with the normal system. Along the way, he made some cool GIF animations. Here's an early GIF he made. This is 100,000 particles and still running pretty fast in Unity, but only about half as fast as he wanted it to be. So he kept working on it, and now here he's got 1 million particles. You can fly right into them, and doesn't slow down the rendering. So, and here's one more, 300,000 particles all using complex movement with no impact on performance. So he hit his performance targets and then had to build some modules to get him in the game. So here we can see now running around, picked up a scent trail of some elk. You can see their smelly footprints here on the ground and follow them. And it's pretty cool to have this many ground particles on the ground, both to help you find the herd as well as even just chasing the herd in scent view and just seeing all these scents that they're leaving behind in the environment. So that's quite a large chunk of Nick's time lately, but I think it's worth it in the big picture to get these scents, so we've really got no upper limit on how many scents we can render in the game. Of course, with optimizations, as many other things, it's sometimes two steps forward and one step back, or in the case of some of these elk, no steps at all. They are not all playing their running animations, aren't they? And we think that might be the result of another optimization, but we're on it, we're getting it fixed, and everything is moving smoothly, whether legs are moving or not, towards the release of WolfQuest 3.